Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, July 6th, we'll talk about God who is above all. We all know that, but we have to remember now and then. Joshua 5:15 says, "The commander of the Lord's army replied, 'Take off your sandals, for the place where you are standing is holy.'" So then Joshua fell face down to the ground in reverence. When Joshua was standing near Jericho, he was at the crossroads and was very apprehensive about the war that they were going to wage against Jericho. At that moment, Son of God appeared in the form of a human with a drawn sword. He came to tell Joshua that he, as the commander of the army of the Lord, is ready to help them. When Joshua realized that he saw God himself, he fell face down to the ground in reverence. Although Joshua was Israel's leader, he was still subordinate to God, who is the absolute leader. Awe and respect are the responses due to our holy God. We should recognize God's power, authority, and deep love, and our actions must model our absolute reverence for God. Joshua had to learn this truth as he began his leadership role. Lord is above all supreme. He is self-existing God, while Satan is a created being. Sovereign reign and authority of God is not understood by all, even Christians. On many occasions, they believe, behave, and even pray as if God is just equal to that of Satan. They consider that there are two equal forces in conflict. This is not a Christian or biblical worldview. God has absolute authority over all heaven, earth, and humanity. Satan has usurped authority over limited sphere, that too with permissible operational power. He had to take permission from God. In Job's case, Satan didn't have power to harm or inflict loss on Job. However, he cannot touch Job. He could damage only his possessions. Satan has to get permission again to physically harm Job. However, Satan was denied permission to take life of Job because God is the author of life. Satan had to ask permission to sift or test Peter. Lord Jesus said to Peter, "Simon, Simon, behold, Satan demanded to have you that he might sift you like the wheat, but I have prayed for you that your faith may not fail." This we see in Luke 22:31-32. Keeping this in mind, I keep asking the Lord to pray for me just like he prayed for Peter. This is very frequently done by me. God has absolute authority and reigns all aspects of life and intervenes in history as required. Even a bird does not fall down dead without his knowledge. So does a hair from the head of his people. Matthew 10:29-30, Jesus himself says. When we understand God as sovereign, absolute, and almighty, we need not be afraid of anything that's happening around us or in our own lives. The very fact that our Lord and God is above all gives us the much needed comfort and strength. Let's pray. Lord, thank you for teaching us that you are a God above all. Yes, Lord, this truth gives us absolute comfort, Lord. Please keep reminding us this. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen. God bless you.